Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Billy Bravo Career Mode series here in Madden 17 on the Xbox One. Now, Billy Bravo, my two-sport athlete, pitches for the Colorado Rockies and, in the same town here, very conveniently, starts at quarterback for the Denver Broncos now that Madden 17 has rolled around. So the Broncos, in their world championship title defense, but without Peyton Manning, turn to the rookie Billy Bravo. He is 2 wins and 2 losses to start the season, at least the team is. And there's his performance last week, 2 interceptions. Kind of hurt in a loss, but now they got to turn their attention to the 4-0 Atlanta Falcons coming to town. This will be a home game, and we're going to go ahead and wear the orange crush throwbacks. I love them so much. The John Elway days. Looking at Bravo and 7 in those orange crush jerseys. Very much brings back Elway reminiscing, but this is a brand new era of Broncos football with Billy Bravo, and we'll see what he can do against an undefeated team. Well, they're going to send a blitz right away, and he recognizes that. He goes to Virgil Green right in the space vacated by the blitz. That works out well. They got a 3rd and 8 here now that he's going to try to convert. He's going to roll to the right and just dump that at the feet, incomplete, avoiding a sack, and they will go ahead and punt on their first possession. So we wait to see what the Falcons and Matt Ryan do on offense. They get stopped as well. So neither team scores in their first possession, and here comes Billy Bravo out once again, and they are deep in their own end on the 7-yard line. Handoff to C.J. Anderson. He breaks a tackle. He trucks over a man, and he's got daylight in front of him. He's loose, and he's going to go all the way for a 93-yard touchdown. Oh, my goodness. They got through the first line of defense, and then there was nothing else. As you watch right here, he runs over a man, and it's just a foot race from there. No one catching C.J. Anderson. Wow, okay, last week, I think he had like 6 carries for 3 yards. He went backwards, essentially, all day. But that's going to change today. He's almost guaranteed a 100-yard rushing day. Atlanta comes right back on their possession and ties up the game. So Matt Ryan says, okay, we can get down there and score points as well. We're 4-0. We'll hang with you today. So late in the first quarter, we got play action rolling, and he's nailed, but he gets that ball out to Demaryius Thomas. Obviously, for many reasons, one of his favorite targets. He's an explosive wide receiver in this league. He even made Tim Tebow look good at times. So it would be wise to lean on him. This is C.J. Anderson. And again, he's loose. And again, to pay dirt. This, the perfect call right here as he goes off left tackle. He only has one defender to deal with. And, well, you know what? He ran him over again. Let's watch this. Just protects that football. And, yeah, point of contact there. The win goes to C.J. Anderson, and he finds himself in the end zone again. Well, he's definitely over 100 yards now. Oh, yeah, nice try at tackling, but next time, come a little stronger than that. Broncos, 2 long rushing touchdowns by C.J. Anderson, and they have started this game about as perfect as you could ask. At least from an offensive perspective, the defense, you know, usually carries us, and, well, okay, they make a stop that time. So it's 14-7 when we get the football back about 8 minutes before halftime, and there's another run. This time Ronnie Hillman checking into the game. Okay, so he's got a couple carries. Billy Bravo looking at a 2nd and 10. He hangs in there. He finds his man over the middle. That's Demaryius Thomas again. He is going to pick up a Denver Broncos first down. Yeah. Okay, Bravo happy with that, as he's able to find his main man again. Oh, Ronnie Hillman. Oh, Ronnie Hillman. What? Did you see that? Not one, but 2 ankle-breaking spins. The spin move in Madden 17 is just too dangerous for defenders. Leave them lying on the turf, and it's another long touchdown, this time by Ronnie Hillman. Look at 1 spin. 2 spins. They have no answer for that. I mean, who can tackle that? Ronnie Hillman just putting on the moves, and then he finds open field for days. The 3rd long Denver rushing touchdown. We went from having a non-existent rushing game. Oh, wow. Every time I see that, I'm like, man, oh, man. Yeah, the running game was non-existent last week. It is here in a big way today, taking over and dominating this 4-0 Atlanta Falcons club so far. Again, it's just worth another look. I hear the Broncos actually cut him in real life, but Ronnie Hillman, that's our backup running back, folks. And he's putting moves on like that. My goodness. Okay, so it's now 21-7. Let's see what the defense does. They get a sack of Matt Ryan, and it's time to punt. So, all right. Now that we got the lead, our defense can kind of pin their ears back and come after Matt Ryan. This is good news here. Always nice to play with the lead. That's just a nice pass over the middle. It's going to be Virgil Green, the tight end, making the catch. Want to be careful here not to force things. Up 14 points and having this running attack just going wild so far. CJ Anderson adding to his totals here in the first half. Play action, though. And wide open is Demaryius Thomas. So see what the run game does for you? It opens up coverage like that on Demaryius Thomas, who is an absolute nightmare mismatch. And yeah, if you're going to go one-on-one, you're going to lose most times matching up with Demaryius Thomas. And obviously, Billy Bravo knows that. He takes his shot after running the ball so successfully, and that pays off for the rookie as he gets the long touchdown strike. It's 28-7. We're not to halftime yet, and it's another punt for the Falcons. So we go back out on the field. Actually, I think that was a turnover, because look at where we are. Yeah, they turned the ball over on their own side of the field. There's going to be a first down throw. Bravo, 7-11. And he's got over 100 yards. They're going to blitz him right there, though. Yeah, jailbreak. He had no chance but to go down to the turf there. Can't even get outside the hashes to throw that one away. So 3rd and 19. And this time, he's going to lob it. That is a catch and a touchdown. That is second-year man Benny Fowler out of Michigan State. He joins in on the fun as that is Bravo's second touchdown pass of the day. You've run three in. You've thrown two in the first half. And you are just absolutely slashing the defense of a previously unbeaten team. 4-0 coming into this game. Yeah, we had our worries. Just 2-2 playing 500 football. But looks like we're already well on our way to a win today. And it's not halftime. Again, we've got the football back. Just thinking, eh, we'll run this clock out. Maybe. They give us 7 or 8 yards right there. 2nd and 2. I don't know. Let's see what we can do here without forcing it too badly. That's right over the middle. It's caught at the 29. And just like that, Brandon McManus is going to have a chance to boot that field goal. He makes it 38-7 at halftime. Atlanta comes out after the half and scores a touchdown. So it's 38-14. But where have they been all game? They've got a lot of work to do to get back into this. 3rd and 2. They bring a rush, and that's a short pass turned into a longer gain. The tight end running with it out to the 48-yard line of the Falcons. First down, and Bravo's over 200 yards passing with those two touchdowns. All right, so here we go back to the running game. Don't care if it's Anderson or Hillman. It's all good. Now, Anderson well over 100 yards. Yeah, like I said last week, 6 rushes for 3 yards. Right now, he's at 171 with 12 carries. What a difference a week makes. Want to get Ronnie Hillman there as well, though, to the 100-yard mark if we can. He had that long run on his own. So if we check him back in, unfortunately, when I'm playing career mode, I don't have the option to mess with the depth chart and let him get more carries. So it's going to have to happen in the course of our dealings here with whatever they call for personnel. That was a sack, and they finally stopped Denver's offense. So, well, that was good for Atlanta, I guess. You got to stop him at some point. Already given up 38 points, but we got another turnover. And it's deep inside their own territory, the Falcons, that is. Get a handoff and to see if the running game can get going again. That was C.J. Anderson. Now we're going to try to pass. 2nd and 12, over the middle. It's caught. Are you kidding me? Demaryius Thomas is second of the game. Falls in over the goal line, and that is Billy Bravo's 3rd touchdown pass of the day. They had 3 running touchdowns, now 3 passing touchdowns. And like I said, are absolutely torching this Falcons ball club, who probably wish they could just hit the reset button right about now. Although they do come back and score. They're going to try to keep this a game in the fourth quarter. It's a shootout, 45-21. Bravo hitting the field again with his offense. Going to be under 7 minutes to play now, and he goes play action. And he's got all sorts of time to think about it. Heaves it deep this time. Emmanuel Sanders is wide open in the end zone. The long bomb play action pays off. The 4th touchdown pass of the day. As you see, he just kind of heaves this Hail Mary style, except, Emmanuel Sanders is well behind the defense. The play action just absolutely messes with them again. And why wouldn't it? They've got two runners going nuts on them right now in this game. So for some reason, the Falcons settle for a field goal there. That's not at all what they needed. And it's 52-24, and it's Ronnie Hillman back in the game trying to get his 100 yards. Looks like he's up over 80 now. Let's say 86. Okay, so maybe he can finish it off with, oh, it's a spin move again. And look at this. You have got to be kidding me. Everything going right for the Broncos run game. And Ronnie Hillman is the master of that spin move. Now, two different occasions. He did two on the first one, but did you see that? I mean, that's not even fair. How is he supposed to ever make a tackle on that? See him just go flying right by him. And again, finds that open space to ramble for a touchdown. So now I cannot wait to see the final rushing numbers in this game. Well, all the numbers, passing and rushing. We put 59 points on these guys. They're still not done. They've scored 31. That should win almost any week of the season, but not this time. So just seconds left. Handoff, and that's going to be C.J. Anderson getting himself over 190. So let's see these totals for these two running backs in a second here. 59-31. Well, the Falcons are unbeaten no more. Matt Ryan wants nothing to do with a camera in his face right there. Billy Bravo, on the other hand, feeling quite good about what his team just did right there. Had some offensive struggles last week, but this time around, not so much. Let's go to the stats. 16 of 21 for 271, four touchdowns, no interceptions for Billy Bravo. Great game, but that all kicked in after the running game got going. And that running game, 22 carries for 191 for Anderson, five carries for 149 for Ronnie Hillman. Both have two touchdowns. That is an amazing running back duo right there. Let's keep that going from week to week, and we'll be golden. So there you see the receiving numbers. Obviously, everyone with a big day in that respect as well, including Benny Fowler getting into the end zone. So nice job. Demaryius Thomas leads the way there, obviously, with two touchdowns. Emmanuel Sanders had the really long one as well. Wow. The Broncos offense clicking on all cylinders, taking down a previously unbeaten team. Now that puts us at 3-2 in the division, tied with the Raiders and one game behind the Chiefs early on here in the AFC West. Next up, we have a game against the San Diego Chargers, who are 1-4. It'll be a road game, but we will be looking to get our fourth win of the season. Come on back for more Billy Bravo Career Mode. We'll see you then. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotasFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is the place.